And okay, so let us start. Ayan. So, good day po to both of you. So, we're going to discuss yung ating last lesson for your second module, which is your 502, HSC 502. So, we're going to the third learning outcomes, which is the different systems, policies, and procedures in health and social care service to improve quality. Okay. So, lahat ng mga pinag-usapan natin with the previous meeting are all about relationship of quality in health and social care. And so, the specific learning outcomes that you are about to learn for these specific lessons are the following. First is to evaluate the methods by which health and social care can gather feedback to improve quality. Second, to identify the stakeholders in the improvement of quality delivery in health and social care, and evaluate strategies that can be used to improve service users' safety. And so, first is we're going to talk about ano-ano ba yung may iba't ibang methods by which health and social care gather feedback to improve quality. Okay, so one way or the other, no, if you are working to any type of profession, organization, there will be always a pros and cons in terms of the services. There will always be a positive and a negative feedback on the services that we provide. Okay, and this feedbacks are very important for the organization to determine whether they are providing the appropriate and quality services that they should provide to their own service users, or service users is also termed as our patients. Okay, so how are the different organizations gather different feedback so that they can utilize it for the improvement of their own quality services? Okay, so ano ba ang feedback? So, of course, alam natin, we all have an idea on what a feedback is. Di ba? So, minsan, pag meron pinatry sa'yo, okay, meron kang gamit or meron kang napuntahan na isang lugar, then if you have your comment, your own opinion, that is considered as your feedback. Whether that's a positive or a negative one. Okay. So, pag sinabi mong feedback, this is the transmission of evaluative or corrective information about an action, writing event, or process to the original or controlling source. Okay. So, usually, we talk about customer's feedback. Okay. Whether, kasi lahat naman sa lahat ng professions, lahat ng pinagsisilbihan ng organizations, you call them as your customers. So, these are the invaluable information and customer opinions provided, of course, by the customers tungkol sa kanilang experience, their own perception, yung kanilang customer expectations with yung product or servisyo na binibigay or natanggap nila or nakuha nila or na-experience nila. So, that is the customer feedback. But since we are talking about healthcare, we'll later on focus on our own patient feedback. Okay. So, bakit ba napaka-importante? Why feedback is very important in improving quality? Okay. So, in health and social care, we do all know that sometimes feedback is often overlooked. Okay? Minsan hindi yan nabibigyan ng pansin or minsan underrated siya. Okay? So in health and social care, this is very important to understand the experiences as well as the different perspective ng mga tao na nakakuha ng service. Okay? So care feedback covers a diverse array of expression that is ranging from yung iba't ibang type ng assessment, whether it's formal, comment, and suggestion. Okay. So, So feedback is important for the following reasons. First is for quality assurance and improvement. Second, for empowering service user. Third is for accountability and transparency. And fourth one is for cultivating a culture of continuous learning. Okay. So paano siya importante in terms of the in terms of quality assurance. Okay. So in health and social care, feedback can be used to measure the quality of services that health and social care practitioner offers. Okay? These are very important or valuable insights into the areas of the strength and weaknesses ng serbisyo na kailangang i-improve. So, take note that when feedback is analyzes correctly, tayong mga care providers can identify those gaps in service delivery. That would be a very helpful tool to address any deficiencies and so that we can implement the right methods, how we can improve or enhance our overall quality of care. Okay. Pangalawa, it is very important, sabi natin, for the empowerment of our patients. So, feedback empowers people drawing on care by giving them a platform to voice or to speak out their concerns, preferences, and their needs. Okay? So, gaya ng sabi ko kanina, a feedback can be a positive or a negative one. So, whether it's through their satisfaction surveys or informal discussions with the providers, yung pagsusolicit or pagkuha ng feedback is tinutulungan natin yung mga patient natin to actively participate in terms of decision that affects their health and well-being. Third, it is important for accountability and transparency. So feedback plays a vital role in holding care providers that are accountable for their actions and ensuring transparency in service delivery. And last one, it is important for cultivating a culture of continuous learning. Okay, so take note that feedback fuels a culture of continuous learning and professional development among care providers. And so those are the reasons why feedback is very important. Okay, so what are the different methods on how to collect feedback on health and social care? So in every organization, may iba't iba silang strategy, may iba't iba silang protocol strategies kung paano sila magko-collect ng feedback. Okay? So in health and social care, these are the common ways on how they are collecting feedback. First is feedback that is via a feedback form on their care home or their facility. CQC inspection feedback, service user feedback mechanisms, and feedback from staff and leaders. Okay, so let us discuss them one by one. Okay, first is the care home feedback form. So this is a structured feedback form to gather information regarding the different various aspects of care. Okay? So, sa mga care home, so if they are using a feedback form, usually ginagamit nila sorry. So, for this specific type of form, they usually use this for the residents and their families with regards to asking them how about their care, the response of the staff, pwedeng cleanliness ng facility, and overall satisfaction ng mga clients dun sa facility itself. So, itong feedback form will be invaluable. So, this type of form will be invaluable when it comes to identifying areas na mga kailangang improve and adjust to meet diverse needs of service user. So, usually, ginagamit ang mga itong care home feedback form to assess yung basic services ng facility. So, take note, feedback, hindi lang yan kinukuha sa mga pasyente. So, kailangan din ng feedback from higher authorities para sa mga nagbibigay ng serbisyo. Okay? So, we had discussion last time that healthcare facilities are being inspected by CQC. So, they are the higher authority to inspect the services. Okay? So, feedback coming from authorized organizations on how the services is being delivered through different healthcare facilities is very important for the employees, okay, as well as those people who are running the administration. Kasi kung walang mga higher authorities or inspections, walang mga feedback galing sa inspection, so walang hindi malalaman ng mga organizations kung kumusta yung serbisyo nila in terms of care. So there will be a regular inspection of health and social care services, and they are going to assess the compliance with regulatory standards. So yung magiging comment, magiging say ng body na nag-inspect sa isang facility, that is considered as a feedback but coming from an authorized or higher authority. Okay? Pangatlo is the feedback that is called as your service user feedback mechanism. Okay, pag sinabing service user, this is other term for patient. Okay. So these are formal tools to collect feedback from people in their care. So this may include yung mga suggestion boxes, yung mga online service and dedicated feedback helplines. Ayan. So yun yung mga example ng mga mechanism para makapag-assess sila, makakuha sila ng feedback to improve the delivery of service. And lastly is feedback from staff and leaders. Okay. Siyempre, hindi lang naman tayo kumukuha ng feedback sa mga service users natin or sa mga patients natin or sa mga clients. So, feedback also coming from the staff, yung mga employees, and the leaders is also important. Okay. So, this includes constructive feedback about yung quality of care and their experience in their workplace. Okay. So, dapat dito, merong honest and constructive feedback ang bawat staff. So, yung mga staff should take their own responsibility of for their actions. So, feedback may highlight any deficits or deficiencies in staff skill, pwedeng competencies, that could lead to be a more tool to develop goals ng bawat staff or employee. Yan. So those are the different methods. Paano ba kinokollect ang feedback? So you have care home feedback form. You have your CQC inspection feedback, your service user feedback mechanism, and of course, feedback from staff and leaders. So kung titingnan ninyo yung feedback, hindi lang siya patient-centered, hindi lang nakasentro sa pwedeng sabihin or magiging feedback ng pasyente, but rather, it includes the whole environment that is related to the delivery of services. Yeah, so those are the different feedback. But one of the main methods, paano ba ni-improve ng isang organization, especially sa health and social care, ang kanyang servisyo, is kinukuha niya sa tinatawag nating patient feedback. Okay? So, sino ba ang parang pinaka sento ng negosyo or clients natin? Wala tayo, okay? Wala tayong aalagaan kung walang patient. So, patient is one of the most important ingredient in terms of healthcare. Okay? Walang healthcare, walang in-demand na trabaho sa healthcare kung walang mga pasyente. Okay. So, patient is one of the main method to improve quality in healthcare field. Not just in health and social care, but in general, in the healthcare field. Okay. So, as per DAWER of 2024, patient feedback serves as a valuable component when it comes to improving the overall healthcare quality. Okay, so isa sila, o kumbaga sila yung pinaka-main na content para mag-improve ang isang healthcare organization. Okay, so patient feedback is the information of patients' opinions, evaluations, and perceptions about their experiences with a hospital clinic or any healthcare facility or any healthcare center. So that is what patient feedback is. So patient feedback is pwede siyang makuha in terms of the patient's opinion about sa kanilang booking process, pwedeng waiting time, yung interaction nila sa kanilang mga doktor, or pwedeng feedback in terms of yung mga iba't ibang medical staff na nakasalamuhan nila, or pwedeng feedback sa cleanliness ng healthcare facility, medical care facilities, diagnosis ng doktor, overall treatment and medication na na-provide o natanggap ng pasyente, patient safety, billing process, pharmaceutical and availability of medicine, and pwede din feedback on the hospital food and hospital cafeteria. Okay. So, marami kang pwedeng pagkuhanan ng feedback that depends on ano ba ang gusto mong malaman. Okay? Kung gusto mong malaman, kumusta ba yung pakikitungo ng mga staff sa patient? Kung gusto mong malaman, kumusta ba yung pagkain ng mga staff o pagkain ng mga patient? So, lahat yun, pwede mong kuhanan ng feedback. Okay. So, there are, of course, different ways on how to collect patient feedback kagaya din kanina dun sa diniscuss natin iba't ibang method. But, specifically for a patient, we can use surveys and questionnaires. Ayan. So, when you say surveys and questionnaires, ito yung mga tools that can be administered pwedeng manually or digitally. Okay, na pwede nilang sagutan. Pwedeng face-to-face, pwedeng via phone. Okay? So, these are tools that can help identify yung mga quantifiable trends and datas na gustong malaman ng organization. Pwede rin kumuha ng feedback, ng patient feedback, using a focus group. So, pag sinabi mong focus group, this is an alternative method that is being used to enable healthcare professionals to gain ang mas more in-depth insights na experience ng mga pasyente. Kasi nakafocus ka lang, let's say, I just want to get the insights and experience of patients with dementia or patients with like post-stroke patients. So, mas focus siya. We can also get from comments cards and suggestion boxes. Yan. So, this can be encouraged through placing a comment card or suggestion boxes sa mga waiting areas, sa mga lounge. Ayan. So, para i-allow yung mga pasyente na makapag-provide ng feedback nila anonymously. Okay. Another way is through online reviews and social media. Ayan. So, dito, many patients like to share their experience of healthcare that they have received via social media. Lalo ngayon, mahilig ang mga taong mag-post, mag-review ng mga bagay-bagay, servisyo, through their own social media platform. So with that, organization can also utilize this way to collect patient feedback. And of course, they can also use a direct communication. So this is getting patients to open up about their feeling during patient visits. That can be another effective way to gather their own feedback. Yan. So those are the different ways on how do we collect patient feedback. Okay. So we have said that patient feedback is one of the main method to improve quality in terms in health and social care. Okay. So these are the importance why patient feedback can improve quality. Ayan. First is, they improve, of course, the overall quality. Ayan. So, patient feedback, sabi natin, is very useful tool that foster yung quality improvement of care provided pwedeng sa healthcare facility mo, sa hospital. Okay? That when they collect feedback from patient about their different or their various aspect of their healthcare facility at different touch point. So, this contributes to the overall quality performance of the organization. So, ito kasing quality helps you identify, okay, if you want to improve the quality of your services. So, you need to identify some of the issues and concerns ng mga pasyente mo. Kasi for sure, hindi naman lahat ng pasyente is positive on feedback. Mayroong nakakakita ng mga lapses or mayroong nakakakita ng mga pwedeng ma-improve ng isang organization. So, that's why it is very important to improve the overall quality of care. Second, it improves overall patient experience and satisfaction. So, here, patient feedbacks helps us measure patient satisfaction with healthcare services. So kapag nagko-collect tayo ng patient insights and utilize them, that feedback for patients to provide yung mas maganda na medical care and treatment. Ayan. Okay? So, feedback improves also not only the quality of care ng facility, pati yung patient experience and satisfaction ng mga pasyente. Kasi kung nag-gather tayo ng patient feedback, okay, sa ibang pasyente, so ma-improve natin yung servisyo natin, so sa susunod, mas magiging satisfied yung mga service user natin or yung mga pasyente natin. Another importance is to increase patient loyalty. So asking for feedback from patients conveys that you care about their opinions and want to ensure good care for them. So this itself poses a good impression of your healthcare brand and of course nakaka-increase yan ng patient maganda yung patient engagement mo. So babalik-balikan ka ng mga kliyente. So, loyalty would also be leading to the increment side. And it also attracts new patients. So, take note that loyal patients not only choose your healthcare brand over others, but also tend to recommend other people in their own. Okay, di ba? So, kung loyal sila, yan. So, kung loyal sila sa facility, hindi lang sila babalik, pwede ka pa nilang i-recommend or pwede nilang mabanggit yun sa mga kakilala nila. That could help in the attraction of new patients. And lastly, Sorry sa interruption. So, last one is to build good image in the industry. Okay. So, of course, in terms of feedbacking, no? So, bad patients or yung mga may mga negative patient experience are often spread in the form of yung mga reviews or word of mouth in the industry. So, kung maganda, okay, yung feedback na makukuha mo to your patient. Okay? So, syempre yan, malalaman ng iba, may spread sa iba. So, that would help you to build a good image ng organization or ng industry. Okay? So, that's why patient feedback is very important to improve quality. Kasi kung makikita ninyo, it covers the holistic aspect of the delivery of quality care. Okay? So, napaka-importante yung say or napaka-importante yung So that's why patient feedback is one of the main component in terms of improving quality. Kasi kahit sinong organization naman, especially in healthcare, no, all healthcare facility aims to provide a good services, a better, so that we can achieve the so-called quality of care. So define natin yan kung anong quality of care last time. And all of us, a healthcare provider should always provide a quality of care since we don't just care for patient, but rather we are caring with lives. That's why quality of care should be taken into consideration at all times. Yan. Okay? So that's the first part, which is the importance of feedback when it comes to improving quality. Okay. So another ingredient to improving quality aside from feedback are our stakeholders. Okay. So 'di ba madalas naririnig niyo yung word na stakeholders sa mga malalaking kumpanya. So every company, every organization has their own set of stakeholders. So specifically in health and social care, meron din tayong mga main stakeholder. So sino-sino sila at ano ba yung sinasabi nating stakeholders. So by definition, stakeholders are individuals or groups who have an interest in a project and can influence its outcome. So they may support or resist changes that are part of improvement. Yan. So pag sinabi mong stakeholder, ito yung mga taong nasa administrative side or administrative aspect ng isang organization. Yan. So, stakeholders in health and social care may have different sets depende sa organization. Okay, kung sino-sino yung mga gusto nilang i-include. So, stakeholders in health and social care are diverse individuals or groups or organizations that have interests or So these are individuals or groups or organizations that have interest or stake in services that is provided and of course their outcome. Okay. So stakeholders are very important in healthcare because they promote the continued advancement of health-related products, services, research, and programs, as well as control the cost of healthcare services. Okay, so Kumbaga, sa madaling sabi, ang mga stakeholders mo, yan yung mga drivers to let your organization run. Okay? So, yan yung mga, kumbaga, utak ng paano patakbuhin yung ating mga organizations or company. Okay. So, there are four, actually, ganun sabi ko kanina, there are potential stakeholders in health and social care. Okay? Pwedeng yung patient, the families, healthcare providers, healthcare professionals, local authorities, government and regulatory boards, or depende yan sa organizations kung gaano karami ang gusto nilang i-include sa kanilang stakeholder circle. Okay? However, there are four major key stakeholders that who are contributing to improving quality. So among all the list of the stakeholders, ito yung apat na meron silang great impact in terms of quality improvement. So sino-sino sila? You have your policymaker, you have your payer, you have your provider, and you have your patient. So let us know them one by one. So una is the policy maker. So ang pinaka-role niya is more on the context setting ng mga policies, from the name itself, policy maker. So a policy maker establish the framework within which healthcare is provided to the country's citizen. So the policy maker aggregates data from patients, providers, and payers to develop population level metrics that inform the health and health economic policies. Okay, so siya, yan ang pinakatrabaho ni policy maker. The second stakeholder siya tawag natin si payer. So ang pinaka main role naman niya is for the procurement. Okay? So si payer or si payer operationalize the financial elements of policy framework. So payers enroll patients as beneficiaries. So example, yung mga insurance company, yung mga insurance facility that are related dun sa healthcare facility. So sila yung mga payer, especially sa mga pasyenteng may mga insurance. So they provide the payer procure care services that is from the providers on behalf of their patients and their beneficiaries. And yan ang trabaho ni payer. Then of course, yung pinaka-importanting key holder is the patient who receives care provision. So patients are typically the citizens, the voters, and sometimes taxpayer, or anyone can be a patient. Okay? So all of us can be a patient at one time or another. So ang mga patient, they are the one who receive care services from providers, and they are the beneficiary of customers of the payers. And of course, si provider. Yan. So si provider, siyang tagabigay ng services. So they provide health services to patients and maintain health information about them. So yung mga doctors natin, mga caregivers, nurses, therapists, dentists, okay? So, provider also provides and coordinate patient with other providers as care team members. Okay? So, provider is the one who gives or who provides a specific service. Yan. So, those are the four major stakeholders in improving quality. So si policymaker, si patient, si provider, si payer. Okay. So bakit sila importante pagdating sa pag-improve ng quality? So, as feedback is important to quality improvement as well as the stakeholders. So, importante din sila sa pag-improve ng quality. So, paano? Paakit sila importante? Paano sila nagiging important in terms of improving quality? Ayan. First is, they enhance relevance and responsiveness. How? So, stakeholders has a better understanding of what are the perspective, preferences, and priorities of their service user. Okay? So, with this, this can help the organizations design and deliver services that are relevant and responsive to their needs and expectation. Okay? Example, kapag in-engage mo yung mga pasyente at yung mga kanilang mga family members sa quality activities, pwedeng ma-identify doon at ma-address yung mga concerns nila, preferences, yung mga values that could improve their satisfaction and loyalty. Second is to improve quality and safety. Okay. So, this improves the quality and safety of services. So, dahil ang stakeholder can provide valuable insights, feedback, and suggestions that could identify and solve problems. So, kapag ganon, mas effective yung implementation and evaluation ng mga changes. And mas ma-share nila yung mga learnings from sa mga nakuha nila from their patients. Okay? Example, pag in-involve mo yung mga pasyente at family nila sa mga quality management na pwedeng makapag-reduce ng error or harm, so mas na-enhance mo yung patient safety outcome ng mga patient, to which that could lead to quality care. Third one is it can foster trust and transparency. So, stakeholders can also foster trust and transparency among individuals. So, stakeholders can communicate and collaborate more openly and effectively. And of course, they build mutual respect and understanding. Okay. So, sila yung mga better person on how to deal with their employees as well as their service users or mga patients so that they could build and of course implement trust and transparency among them. Yan. So syempre, without stakeholders, we cannot implement these things, no? So kung wala yung mga stakeholders natin, hindi mapapatakbo ng isang organization, yung kanilang organization, okay, nang ganon ka-effective if you don't have the champions or the main person. That's why they are very important in terms of providing quality. Yan, okay? So that is about the stakeholders on how they can contribute to the improvement of quality care services. Yan. And last one is the strategies that can be used to improve service user safety. Okay. So, tapos na tayo sa feedback and stakeholder kung paano sila nakakatulong sa pag-improve ng quality. So, one of the most important thing in healthcare field is to improve patient safety. Okay? Paano tayo masasabihan na may quality care and services tayo kung hindi nila na-feel na safe sila sa atin? So, si safety is very important. Okay? So, according to the World Health Organization, that at least 5 people die every minute because of unsafe care. O, di ba? It's very significant. That's why safe healthcare is a fundamental human right. So, ano ba yung tinatawag natin patient safety? Okay? So, before we define that, let's have some patient safety facts. Okay? So, first one, around 1 in every 10 patients is harmed in health in healthcare, and more than 3 million deaths occur annually. Diba? Can you imagine that? 3 million deaths occur annually due to unsafe care. Another fact is in low to middle income countries, as many as 4 to 100 people die from unsafe care. Okay? About 50% of harm, 1 in every 20 patients, is preventable. Diba? Can you imagine? You can prevent harm or error. And half of this harm is attributed to medications. Some estimates suggest that as many as 4 in 10 patients are harmed in primary and ambulatory settings, while up to 80%, 23.6 to 85% of this harm can be avoided. Then, patient harm potentially reduces global economic growth by 0.7% a year. And on global scale, the indirect cost of harm amounts to trillions of US dollars each year. And lastly, investment in reducing patient harm can lead to significant financial savings and, more importantly, better patient outcomes. Yan. Okay? So, ano ba ang tinatawag nating patient safety? So, patient safety is defined as the absence of preventable harm to a patient and reduction of risk of unnecessary harm associated with health care to an acceptable minimum. So that's the definition from the World Health Organization or the WHO. Okay. So what are the factors? Bakit ba na-experience ang pasyente ang harm? Or what are the factors that leads to patient harm? Okay? First are the systems and organizational factors. Okay, ito yung example natin dito, yung mga inadequate processes and procedures, yung mga disruption ng workflow, resource constraint or kulang sa mga resources, or pwedeng kulang ang staff, or pwedeng may staff pero their competencies are not enough. Yan yung mga example ng systems and organizational factors. Next is yung tinatawag nating technological factors. Siyempre, ito yung mga issues that are related to health information system. Gaya ng mga electronic health record, medication administration system, misuse of technology. So, lahat yun magpo-fall dito sa technological factors. So, that could lead to harm. Another factor that lead to harm is human factors and behavior. Isa ito sa pinaka-common. Example, yung mga communication breakdown among healthcare workers, ineffective teamwork, and fatigue, burnout ng mga staff, and different cognitive biases. Then, patient-related factors. Example, yung mga limited health literacy, lack of engagement, non-adherence to treatment, yun yung mga example. And last one are your external factors, absence of policies, inconsistent regulations, economic and financial pressures, challenges that are related to natural environment. Yan. So all of these factors are one of the leading causes bakit nakaka-experience ang mga patient ng harm. Okay? So, ito yung mga circumstances to which bakit harm is present sa workplace. Okay. So, ano-ano yung mga common, okay, mga common sources ng patient harm? Okay. So, based on studies, these are the top 10. Okay? Top 10 common sources of patient harm. Medication error is one. Ayan, yun yung pinakamataas kung saan nakaka-experience ng harm ang pasyente. Surgical error during operations. Healthcare-associated infections, yung manakuha nilang infection sa mismong facility nung na-admit sila. Mga diagnostic errors, patient falls, harm from venous thromboembolism, that is a condition from pressure ulcers, or pwedeng patient misidentification, or sepsis, this is also a condition, and from unsafe injection practice. So, based on studies, ito yung mga common sources. Bakit nakaka-experience ang pasyente ng harm sa different healthcare facilities. Okay. So, sabi natin kanina, isa sa mga strategies para masabi natin na may quality yung serbisyo na isang facility is dapat safe ang pasyente. Okay? So, ano-ano yung mga pwede natin gawin to improve patient safety? Ano-ano yung mga strategies? Okay? So, these are the strategies on how we can prevent harm. So, initially, we need to create a patient safety culture sa ating mga facilities. Okay? Dapat, safety is everyone's responsibility. Hindi lang ng employee mo, hindi lang ikaw na provider, but lahat-lahat ng nasa organization na yon. Okay? So, these are the following approaches to which we can improve patient safety. First is to have an evidence-based practices for advancing patient safety. Okay? So, ang mga healthcare programs or healthcare providers, dapat gumamit sila ng mga evidence-based. Pag sabi mong evidence-based, napatunayan na yan. Evidence-based practices na magkocontribute sa kanilang patient safety. Bakit? These practices would include identifying and addressing patient safety risk. It would also promote culture of safety at mas ma-encourage mong maging engage yung mga pasyente mo at kanilang mga pasyente, pamilya in terms of their treatment and care. Second is you need to address medical errors and prevent harm, of course. So healthcare providers must address medical errors promptly and develop strategies to prevent harm to patients. So, syempre, this requires identification and reporting. So, hindi mo naman malalaman ang mga error kung walang magre-report. Then, kapag na-report, kailangan i-analyze and to implement any measures para hindi na siya mangyari in the future. Another strategy is to improve patient safety in healthcare setting. Okay, so healthcare providers must ensure patient safety across all the healthcare settings, including yung hospital, long-term facilities, because this will require implementing policies and procedures that prioritize patient safety, gaya ng hygiene protocols, yan, infection of prevention measures, yan. Then, we should also promote a patient safety culture. Yung culture na everyone is responsible for safety. Okay? So, organization should move away from the culture of blame on one recognizing excellence and sharing best practice. Hindi na uso ngayon na sisihin mo yung nagkamali. But rather, okay, try to involve them to activities that would improve their behavior. Okay? Hindi na uso ngayon yung pinpointing na sino ang may kasalanan. Ang uso na ngayon is bakit nangyari yung kasalanan? Bakit nangyari yung mistake? Nasaan yung loophole? Okay? So, that is one of a patient safety culture. Try to look at the system but not the person who committed the mistake. Okay? They are still involved in the system correction. However, hindi na nakafocus lang sa kanila. Okay? Fifth one is to have a policy and procedure updates to prioritize patient safety. That's very self-explanatory. We also need to ensure healthcare for all patients, highlighting the importance of patient safety across a care continuum. So take note, patient safety is a continuous process. Hindi lang yan isang step and then that's it. So it should be a continuous process. So this strategy approach requires a comprehensive approach to patient safety that involves all members of the healthcare team. So, lahat. And lastly, is to allocate tasks effectively. So, the organization should have a technique on how to allocate yung mga different tasks ng kanilang mga employees to prevent harm and to, of course, promote patient safety. Ayan. Okay? So, that is the different strategies on how to prevent patient safety. Yeah. Okay? So as a conclusion, we were able to discuss feedback, the different stakeholders, and patient safety as a main component in improving quality of care. Okay? So yun yung pinaka focus ng lesson. Yung ano-ano yung mga pwedeng makontribute ng feedback, patient safety, at ng stakeholders pagdating sa pag-improve ng quality patient care. Yan. Okay? So, that's the wrap-up of our lesson 3 in your module 502. Okay? Any concerns, questions, clarifications before we move on to the questions na sa assignment ninyo or sa task, naintindihan po ba?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.